impressions?
What?
What's your first impressions?
Huh?
First impression.
Seems like it's fun to ride.
Speak clearly.
Seems like it's fun to ride. Tire seems a little low. Yeah, figure out that clacking noise is. Unless it's just the engine.
You can hear the clacking noise? It's the engine. It's gonna go bad.
It's gonna go about 9,000 miles.
Yeah. Somebody put the wrong oil in it.
That's how it got broken?
Yeah.
Can't you just flush it?
Yeah, I already did. It didn't help.
Did you put some kind of cleaner or anything in it?
It's done for. It's got metal chips inside the filter. So it's got a pretty good engine.
How do you get metal chips inside the filter?
Wrong oil.
Wrong the motor. Oil will fuck it up that bad?
Yeah.
I thought you could at least drain it and then clean it out.
You can if you didn't run it long enough, but this sounds like the dude ran it for a while.
Oh, he didn't know until it was too late.
Yeah, he was an idiot. Yep, here we go. That's so dumb, huh?
What?
That's so dumb, huh? That's one cylinder. Yeah, that sounds like crap, huh? Maybe it's not so bad. Well, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna check to see if it has any more like metal chips after about 500 miles, and see what happens. GoPro, start recording. It looks like she fits on it pretty well.
How much is your brother gonna charge you for it?
well, he bought it for $1,200. He'll charge me like a couple hundred bucks more. So, but I mean, like, I could. It's probably not gonna be a good deal because I'm gonna have to put money into the motor. I mean, so that's like a $3,000 bike if it was worth it. About it, you just do it.
Yeah.
So,
well, what he did is he made it harder for you.
Why?
You changed the gear shifter, didn't you?
No, I didn't touch it.
You didn't touch it at all?
I don't really care about this bike.
This was weird for me, too. It's not.
Was it too high or too low?
Too high.
Really?
Too high. Yeah, lift your foot.
No, it's not that bad. You mean, okay, which is too high, the front or the back?
The front.
Oh. Whatever, it's not that bad. That's how it came.
I was lifting it like how I have to lift it.
Yeah.
I'm just scared if I'm going to put it in neutral instead of...
Who cares? If you put it in neutral, no harm, no foul. It's not a problem.
So what if I put it in neutral and then I try to put it in second, can it accidentally go in third?
No. You have to do it again to put in third.
Well, finally he came out.
The neutral, you have to be really soft on it. If you want to go into second, just hit it, you know, boom, that's it.
Hey, Nicholas. I said we're leaving. Am I going to, like, drag you off the phone?
Dry thing. So turn on the bike so you can see what gear it's in, right? Okay, now put it up and see if it goes in second.
Gear zero, neutral.
Okay, now put it down.
It's not pointing clutch.
Is it in first?
No.
Yeah, don't forget the clutch. Is it in first?
No.
Roll it a little bit forward or backward. Kind of get it. Get the teeth to match. Just kind of roll the bike a little bit.
Oh, like this?
Yeah, just change it. Well, without the clutch, I mean. Okay, there you go. Now push it up harder. It'll go into second.
Okay.
Got it? And it'll be easier once you're riding. Because everything's moving.
So how many miles per hour on average should I be going when I go into second? Like normally. Like you take off at a light. Normal, not you guys.
Feel it. Just feel it. It makes no difference.
Well,
just
I'm still learning to feel it, so
I'd
I'm just.
Say 15.
In this parking lot, you really almost don't even need second.
Well, yeah, but I'm just saying on average.
You're on a smaller bike, so you're gonna go through the gears quicker.
Yeah. Alright.
Well, let's see you do second. I'll go record the kids for a second.
David.
David? Where did you come from?
You already know me.
Oh. Where? I seen you somewhere before.
When you know me.
I saw you before. You look familiar. Kids are playing goats or whatever, huh? You on babysitting duty today, huh? You got the day off, huh?
Yeah, dude, I work 8 days straight.
Really?
Yeah. 8-12.
Yeah, go back at first, just for practice. It's up there. Maybe you should let us sit for a little bit. Yep. Park it.
I'll go to the house and get
No,
David
give him a ride over to the house.
No way, I ain't giving him a ride.
Right, well,
I can barely ride
the
this thing myself.
Park in the shade at least. So you don't want to get back on a hot bike.
Well, go hot that quick.
I don't know. Better be safe than sorry, right? It's more than half, so I don't know what these bikes are supposed to be like. That's my friend Ethan. He's also my neighbor. Power for
I think because like you know how you hear the noise and then you do that.
Yeah.
I think that's just the way it's supposed to sound.
Well, I don't know. But okay, try driving it like low power, like you're almost coasting kinda, and you'll feel that. It does what your bike does. stay in the shade.
Go get a motorcycle and ride with us.
Yeah.
Dead.
It's not that dead. I put it on a charger.
Well, you brought it home.
If it's dead, it should be charging, right?
Towards the cul-de-sac, it's easy to turn around over there. Dave likes riding with you, huh?
David?
Yeah. Ask him if he wants to ride with you.